In part 4, we saw Micah break up with Kwame in a harsh way, sulking and giving monosyllabic responses while he tried to be civil and end on good terms. She then went and laughed about this with Irina. Afterwards, she had to wait for the man she had agreed to be with, Paul, to break up with his other connection, Amber. And we saw Micah's paranoia start to shine through, along with the effects of continued narcissistic wounding. She couldn't sit still. She kept complaining about how long it was taking, even saying, "It took me 2 seconds to end it with Kwame," without realizing how badly that reflected on her. She said she was having really bad anxiety. And finally, she jumped to the conclusion that she just got played like a fiddle. After a while, Amber, who had actually been crying in the dating pod after Paul broke up with her, entered the women's living area.
I need a minute. You sit with me.
Yeah.
I cannot be on
outside. It's okay. That's fine. Where do you want to be?
And one side of me is so happy, like relieved maybe. Maybe more relieved than happy. She actually looked like she was hurt. Like she's actually hurt.
Micah's reaction is a great example of a narcissist initially showing an inappropriate reaction to something due to their lack of emotional empathy, but then catching themselves and correcting this to give the socially appropriate reaction. Mike is smiling and actually starts to laugh upon seeing how upset Amber is. But being a mid-range narcissist, she knows that the correct emotional response here would be concern and moves to show that instead, saying, "She's actually hurt," and putting on a concerned face. If you can't already see how fake this is, it becomes even more obvious in a minute, when her supposed concern completely evaporates. And as usual, Irina doesn't even pretend to look concerned. Unlike Micah, she doesn't have the facade of being a good person.
Then drop me to pieces.
I want it so bad, you know, I really do. And it was not what I was expecting when I walked in there.
Was she crying or laughing?
We see yet another flare-up of paranoia from Micah, showing just how intense this can be in some narcissists. She somehow suddenly seems highly concerned that Amber is actually laughing instead of crying. Presumably, if Amber's laughing, this could mean that Paul didn't break up with her after all. So Micah approaches Irina and asks, "Is she crying or laughing?" Irina doesn't immediately answer the question, saying, "How do you..." And Micah interrupts her, which shows a sense of entitlement and the level of concern from the paranoia she's experiencing. And she asks again, "Is she crying or laughing?"
Crying, but... What's she saying?
Go
stand by the thing and listen. No, but don't be obvious. Don't let them see you.
Micah's smile returns when she hears that Amber is crying. She then enlists Irina to go and spy on Amber's tearful conversation. This shows her lack of emotional empathy and a lack of respect for other people's boundaries while they're clearly having a private conversation. Micah seems to be finding this all very amusing, which shows how fake the glum look and supposed concern for Amber that she showed a minute ago were. Another interesting indicator for narcissism is that Micah is enlisting somebody else to do her dirty work for her, which H.G. Tudor calls the use of a lieutenant, and others call using flying monkeys. This situation shows another reason why two narcissists can work well as friends together. If Micah had told a non-narcissist friend to spy on Amber, they would have almost certainly refused. But Irina, having no emotional empathy herself, does it in a heartbeat.
That's not what he wanted, and that's okay. But I'm just like, you know, you could have been a little bit more forthcoming about where you were at instead of just telling me what I wanted to hear, because now I feel like a fucking idiot because I believed you.
so Irina is straining not to burst out laughing on hearing Amber's tearful voice. As usual, she doesn't even show the pretense of having empathy, which again is due to her lack of cognitive empathy. As I've said before, Irina is a very obvious narcissist. Even people who don't know about narcissism will still often get the feeling that something isn't quite right with her. Which is why, to my eyes, the other women on the show, apart from Micah, seem to be a bit wary of Irina. We saw the sort of "what the hell" glance between two women earlier as Irina was spraying praise over some flowers. And there are more examples to come, such as when a woman tries to warn one of the men about Irina. It also says something about Micah that her closest friend in the show is somebody who behaves this way. And as we'll see later, this interesting choice of friends is not an isolated event with Micah.
When's it gonna be my turn?
I know.
How many times do you see her have to be broken, you know? Figures that, you know,
it looks as though Amber spots Irina spying on her and stops talking. I don't know whether this is actually the case or it's just been made to look like that in the editing, but either way, Irina runs away laughing and shouting, "Abort! Abort!" Again, this shows her absence of emotional empathy. She doesn't care about what Amber's going through, and she doesn't care that her actions will make the situation worse. She has no shame or sense of embarrassment about being caught spying. It's just a funny game to her, and she shows a similar level of emotional maturity to a child on a playground. And again, it shows her lack of facade. She doesn't even pretend to be a nice person, despite knowing that this is being filmed and that her actions will be seen by everyone she knows, as well as millions of other people. This is where Micah differs from Irina. Because Micah does care about how she's perceived. Remember that she didn't want to spy on Amber herself, but instead asked Irina to do it, and was cautious in telling Irina not to be obvious and not to let the other women see her, which of course Irina ignored. The footage skips forwards to Micah and Irina sitting on the sofas. The person who is comforting Amber, Chelsea, approaches them.
Do you think Kwame's gonna leave or do you think he's gonna stay?
Stay, you little villain.
Irina is asking Micah whether she thinks that Kwame is going to leave the show or stay after Micah broke up with him. But Kwame also has a connection with another woman to Micah, which is Chelsea, the person who just comforted Amber and is walking over. She overhears this question and says, "Stay, you little villain." She sits down with Micah and Irina for what looks like a pretty tense situation.
I want to be nicer. I'm like not nice at all.
Why don't you then?
What?
Why don't you then?
Chelsea's right. If Irina genuinely wanted to be nicer, she would already be taking steps to improve her behavior. In reality, she doesn't actually want to be nicer. This is just a manipulation that narcissists use to get themselves out of trouble. In this case, to get Chelsea off her back. It's called promised change. However, here it doesn't work because Chelsea questions this, which challenges Irina, who, being a narcissist, will need to nullify this challenge to her control somehow.
Why don't you then?
What?
Why don't you then?
I don't know, because I'm like feeling real emotions and it's like just like all of it's a lot, dude.
And there's the blame shifting that you'll almost always see from a narcissist when somebody is trying to hold them to account for their behavior. It's a manipulation and it shows a lack of accountability. A higher echelon narcissist would be able to come up with a more convincing justification for their behavior here. Perhaps saying how they're overcome with stress, terrified of being rejected, or their low self-esteem is making them lash out. But as we'll keep seeing with Irina, she isn't capable of this type of mid-range manipulation, and instead sounds utterly unconvincing.
It's just like all of it's a lot, dude.
Yeah, it's true. It is. I heard people that talk bad about one another is because they don't aren't cool with themselves, you know?
Yeah.
This is a game, dude.
Generally speaking, calling out a narcissist is counterproductive. Although you're challenging their sense of control, which they'll have to deal with somehow, at the same time, you're providing them with the thing that they value most in this world, emotional fuel. They're hearing the anger and frustration in your voice and feeling a surge of power, because subconsciously this is telling them that they're important enough to create this reaction in you. They're feeding off your emotions. In this case, I suppose there's at least some value in Chelsea confronting Micah and Irina here. Because this is being filmed, in a way she's helping to expose their poor behaviour and giving the viewers a virtual win on calling them out. But never delude yourself into thinking, yeah, I really showed that narcissist by having a go at them. Because you didn't. You got yourself worked up emotionally and gave the narcissist a huge dollop of fuel. A narcissist is never going to see the truth of the situation and change their ways. You cannot convince them that they're in the wrong and need to change. They might pretend to see the light in order to manipulate you and stop you from threatening their control, but they don't genuinely think that they did anything wrong. And at some future point in time, they'll say something which makes you realize that they never accepted wrongdoing from the start. That wraps up part 5. Thank you for listening, and please subscribe to my channel for future videos.